No, let's start.
Yeah.
Leadership is a skill that determines your goal and your success. It's so important. Leadership is what attracts good prospects to your business. It's what determines how motivated your demands are. Leadership is what makes your business grow or dead. Leadership is a responsibility and not a privilege. But having just leadership is not enough. Leadership should be characterized by two important qualities. Servant-driven leadership. What exactly means having servant-driven leadership? Servant leadership. If you think about it, the two words really should cancel each other, or they cancel itself. The servant is one service, is one who serves, and the leader is one who usually gets served. This is the traditional way things happen. You know, this is the traditional way everybody think. But the leader? The leader is what they say to do, and the people, they do it. But this is a common belief, because an exceptional leader makes exactly the opposite. Fortunately, the role of leadership has been redefined on the past several years. And the true leader, who often is considered as the person that makes the thing happen, does it with a servant leadership mentality. So, what is a servant leadership mentality? What is it? The term servant leadership mentality, the servant leadership was coined by 1970 by Robert Greenleaf in one of his books entitled The Servant as Leader. He says that when someone wants to serve, and serve anything and serves, the this position in turn gets a tendency to try to achieve another goal. This is much different from someone who comes from a place of a leader first. Greenleaf explains that the person creates looks at the satisfaction in acquiring material things, and the leader, this is a leader first mentality. This leader's self first mentality are focused on the meeting the needs of those who follow them. The priority are the needs, not the leaders. It's through this leadership that people grow healthier and makes the life desire of the people. The servant leadership has qualities that are essential in the lasting relationship. Have a stronger team and become successful. Makes the team successful. So today I want to talk about 8 important characteristics that distinguish the servant type of leadership among the many others. The first one is encouragement. A servant leadership is always encouraging. He knows how to encourage others. He has the ability to recognize when someone needs to be encouraged. Sometimes it can be a personal pest, or because has no self-confidence in himself. Or maybe he's tried to another network marketing before and failed. You know, there can be a lot of reasons why one needs encouragement. But the servant leader can recognize the need and can feel it. Always serving, always serving. The next quality is the selflessness. The selflessness. With the it's about you, not me mindset, the servant leader is here to make help a lot of people as much as he can. People need value needs, no? And the servant leader knows that is a responsibility, makes to provide issues to whatever problem people have. And when he does it sincerely, setting aside all his convenience, needs, or wants. Never worry about the commission or recognition or whatever. He will be always there to help others. Quality number three, you can see that, ability to sway one's thinking. Servant leadership is never about telling anyone what to do. Anyone. You know, it's never about using your authority, never. But it's about knowing and understanding your team, providing beneficial information, sharing stories, and give to them the chance to take from what you provide so that they can take their own decision. Traditionally, it's important to connect with them on an emotional level and modify the message to fit them. Characteristic number four, be humble, be humble. Always portray a side of you that does not give the impression that you are better than the other people, never. Because people want to feel respected and need understanding. Remember where you come from and how you learn what all you know. Remember, people are at different levels and they need someone that they identify with. So always be willing to help them, always. If you stay humble, you will be more successful in building a trusting relationship. We are part of the Genes family, you know. And we have another benefit as part of it, is the ability of having the top owners provide value weekly through webinar meetings and much more. Is anyone any questions? If anyone has questions, these top owners are always ready, willing, and available to assist us. They never give the impression they are too busy or too important to do so. This is beautiful. The next quality to have forever good servant driving leadership is number five, is good listener. The servant driving leader demonstrates good listening skills and listens to others say, what others say, really listens, really listens. Many times, it's what the person doesn't say as well as what he does. You know, people want to be heard and they have a problem and an issue, you know? And we want to know with someone that take the time to help them. And once you have heard the story, the issue, the concern, or desire, you are in better position to share your expertise. This doesn't prospect that you are truly a reader, take the time to listen, and really want to help the other people. Number six, authenticity. This is the significant factor, as it able to show very clearly to the team that not only you can be themselves, but also that they are work in a work environment and they welcome this. To show authenticity, the servant leader must act with integrity. They must do as they as promised, show consistency in actions and morality, and be true to themselves and the spirits of the leadership principle they preach. Attention. The benefit of authenticity is that ultimately it supports and reinforces the values of the servant leader. Number seven, providing direction. Knowing what the servant leader expects of them is beneficial for team or organization. To provide directions, the servant leader must make work dynamic and have it tailored to the abilities and needs of the team. The number 8, foresight. Having the ability to learn from the past experience, what's happening in the present, and the probability of what's happening in the future is a foresight. And there's another quality of a servant leader. Everything is connected, the past, the present, and the future. Servant leader has an intuitive ability to preview what's happening in the future. This is because it's based on the past and the present experience. You know, there are a lot of qualities of servant leadership, but we don't have time now to explain so many qualities. There's a lot, because my time is almost finished. But if you are decided to be the leader in this company, it would benefit you to give the attitude of servant mentality. Showing people that you care and you are there to learn and to be as service, but not at their service, give you the best position to be a servant, driver, leader. So thank you so much. See you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thanks. Bye-bye. Thank you.